Still got a little bit going on. Leave all these women alone, man. All these women alone. You can find all these women in the black community at any time, any moment. You can find any of these women out there. Leave them all alone. I'm gonna tell you who you need to be with. I'm gonna show you who you need to be with. You need to be with a good woman. Well, what are the traits of a good woman? What kind of things should you look for when you're trying to find a good woman? You want a woman to have concern for other people. A woman should be concerned for other people. They shouldn't be not, you know, I'm not going to be concerned about anyone else. And just, they should be concerned for others. That's part of a woman being a woman. Another thing, they should be virtuous. They should have virtue, man. They should be able to connect. What I mean by virtuous, they should be able to connect through an unspoken spiritual right and wrong standard of awareness and behavior. This is what I'm calling virtue. This is I'm defining virtue with what I'm using it for. Meaning that you should not have to communicate to this woman that she should be a woman. You should not have to communicate to her that she should, you know, be, you know, gentle enough for you. You shouldn't have to communicate these things. She should be virtuous enough to understand that this is an uncommunicated thing. So I don't have to communicate this verbally to you. You should have the same spirit like me. And this virtue just makes us be able to connect together like Legos. You want a virtuous woman, man. A concern for others, virtuous. Aware of how others will see you based on her. Yeah. You want a woman that's gonna say, okay, I'm not just gonna fall out the bed and come out there, cause I know I'm gonna be with you. I'm representing you. I'm going over your mama's house. I'm going over your boy's house. I'm going with you to the store. I'm going with you out. You want women that's gonna be concerned of how they present themselves, because they know, they understand that you are gonna be. They represent you and the foundation that you're trying to set up. They represent the order you're trying to set up, and they want to present you in a good light. That's what you want. They encourage you to be a man. They encourage you to go for your dreams and be a man. They with you. Once they realize what you're really trying to do, they do a gut check, and they find out that, hey, this man want to do that. Hey, he want to go on a space ride. I better sew him a spacesuit. Once they dig in and they realize that that's what they're gonna do, man, that's the kind of woman you want. I'll encourage you to be a man. Not emasculating you, encouraging you to be a man. Knows how and when to be a lady. Yeah. There's a time to do everything, but there's a way and a time to do everything. You don't want somebody that's in your life that doesn't know how to be a lady, man. You don't want that. Ratchet women do not know how to be a lady. They can fake the funk for a minute, but they don't know how to be a lady for real. You want a black woman that's going to be a lady for real. A lady that knows how to conduct themselves. And a lady knows when to let you be a man and handle your business. Anyway, compliments your personality. Not mean they got to physically give you compliments. Oh, you look so nice. No. When I mean compliment, I mean where you are not as strong, they make up for that. And where she's not that strong, you make up for that. That's called complimenting each other. That's what you want. You don't want somebody that's just as strong as you, or just as has much as machismo as you. You don't want that. That's not gonna last you in the long run. You're gonna realize, wow, I'm with kind of like a man here. and I don't like men, but I don't, this is what I walk myself into. Anyway, you want your woman to impress your friends and family. You want them, when your family meets these people, you want your family to say, wow, man, you hit the jackpot with that one. You did good, man. I could see that she's, you know, she's going to be good to you. She ain't perfect, but she's definitely, her heart is in the right place. That's what you want your family to say. You don't want your family to say, hey, one time my brother came into the house to have me meet his first wife. And I said, as soon as I talked to her about 5 minutes, and she stepped outside to smoke, and I told my brother, I said, man, drop that girl. I should drop her. She is not right for you. Drop her. I mean, I could see that right away. He didn't listen to me, but that's a whole nother story. But you want your family, you don't want your family to say, you want what you, what I should have been saying about her was, man, wow, you know, she seems like a real good person. You know, you listen, you know, you should, you know, you should be proud of yourself for, you know, being able to have somebody like that with you. Anyway, make sure your woman is, if your family's not impressed with her, then there's something you need to think about that. She is, this woman is bothered when you haven't eaten. Now, this is a trait that most black women are, today's black women are really not like that, but it's, but so you got to find one that is. You got to find, you just got to keep looking, man. It's 16 to 1, so there's plenty of women out there for you to find one that does these things. A good woman is going to be bothered, man. They're going to find out, if they haven't seen you for a long time, they haven't talked to you all day or whatever, you've been working, they've been working, the first thing they're going to ask you is, have you eaten? If they haven't, if they're not concerned whether you've eaten or not, and it's in a 24-hour period, bro, you need to get rid of that woman, because that woman is faking the funk. A good woman is going to be concerned that you haven't eaten, because she knows that you are the workhorse, and the workhorse needs to eat. Creates, and she just love you and just concerned about you, period, as a person. She may not even, you may just be starting out a relationship, but she just concerned for you as a person. Anyway, creates an environment of peace for you at home. When she's around you, this woman creates an environment of peace. She ain't got a lot of drama going on. Her brother might call, her mama might call, her sister might call, but she said, hey, look, I'm with my man right now, you know, we'll deal with that later. We're doing this right now, and we on a date, and we're doing this, and we're enjoying our time. And she lets everybody know, hey, this is, we doing our thing. We, you know, you can't come, you're not going to put your drama on us. She creates an environment, I should say and, it says creates and, creates an environment of peace for you at home. At home or wherever she's at with you, just when her presence, she's creating an environment of peace for you, because she knows how hard you work. I mean, you need somebody to compliment you like that. Doesn't override your decisions, but reverse her concerns. Yeah, you don't need somebody you say, shut up, girl, this is what we doing, and she said, okay. No, you need somebody that, if they have a problem with something you doing, they'll say something. My man, look here, I got a degree in finance, so trust me, what you about to do, that's not, you should, you paying too much for that, car you buying. Let's go to another lot. You know, any normal, any dude with any sense in his head gonna say, well, this girl got a degree, or she know about cars, she know about this kind of stuff. Let me listen to my girl. Why would she, my girl want me to not have what I want? See, so a real woman is gonna voice her concerns. Now, if you still go along and do it the way you want to do it, she gonna support you, she ain't gonna like it, but she gonna tell you her concerns, but then she gonna at some point leave it alone. The next thing is sexually stimulating. You gotta have somebody that's sexually stimulating for you, man. If they do all of this stuff and they're not sexually stimulating, and you can't make them sexually stimulate, you can't suggest things to them to get sexually stimulated, this ain't gonna work. None of this is gonna work. You gotta have all of this stuff going on, man. You got to have all of this stuff going on. The more stuff you got going on this list, the better chances you have of having a relationship with somebody that's going to be positive. We got it? I mean, that's all I want, is for us to have positive relationships so we can fix our community. We can't fix our community if we don't have good families. And we only got to have good families when the good of our people come together. Right now, there's so many bad people out there. The good people are running into bad people and getting caught up. We need to have more good people out there so good people can run into good people. and we can start building these families. I'm just saying these ratchet women, they need help, and if you can't help them, unless you're a pastor or something, you can't help these people, man. And you definitely can't help them and be romantically involved with them. You can't do it. So you're gonna have to do one or the other. And my suggestion is to help them from the outside, not the inside. Anyway, lastly, enjoy your life, man. Have a good time. You put here on this planet to enjoy yourself and enjoy God's greatest gift to the black man, the black woman. That's our greatest gift, brother. And we got to take that. Okay, we're going to do four things for us. Actually, I'm going to actually do five things for us. Number one, rate this video. Give us a rating. Let us know if you like what we're trying to do. Tell us what you think and what we can do to improve, to make the people get better. Because that's the ultimate goal, is to get these men and women to stop going to prison and start building better black families and better black people, so we can all be better people on this planet. Next, give us your comment. You know, tell us what you think and what we can do to improve, to help the people get better. Like I said, that's the ultimate goal. If you think what we say makes sense, talk about it and leave us a comment. We appreciate that. And that'll get the ball rolling, and then we'll start talking about some of these tough issues, and maybe we can do something about them. Next thing is to like this video. If you like what was said or something we're doing, we would like to know that you support us. We're not asking for donations, just the push of a button. That's all we ask for. A few clicks of the button, a few clicks of the mouse screen, a few clicks of the mouse, and then they'll show us that you support what we're doing. Share this video. Next thing is to share this video. Share this video in your social network. If you like what was said or something we're doing, please share this video on your social media network and talk about it with your friends. If you think people need to hear this message, then please share it as much as possible. Thanks for your support. Yeah, just share as much as possible with this video. You might have a nephew or cousin that needs to hear this kind of thing, or might have people in your own network that need to hear this. Just on your social network, just please share it as much as possible. And the last thing is, remember, we have the Urban Male Life Skills Boot Camps. That's our flagship program. We have other things. We have the home study course. We have the worksheets and workbooks. But this is the flagship program to help our people try to get better, so that we can stop having these young men and women go to prisons, particularly the men, because once we get the men, then I believe that the women will follow. So once we get them to stop going to prisons, then the women will follow, and then we'll bring our community closer together, and we can stop being in a pitiful condition we're in and start standing up and doing some things to help our people get employed and have better lifestyles. So anyway, those are the things that we need you to do. We ask you to do. Please help us in this cause. Thanks a lot.